Hey friends, it's Easter night around 10 o'clock and my husband and I are sitting in the kitchen. He's helping me videotape this. And I was just thinking today about the resurrection, and I actually got to thinking about Wonder Woman. Remember her? Sometimes I wish I was Wonder Woman. I mean, she was pretty cool. She had the lasso and the flying plane and those things on her arms that she could like fight things off. Sometimes it seems like I need to overwhelmingly jump over tall buildings and move mountains and things that I just can't do, and I wish I had a superpower. But this morning I was at church and the pastors were introducing the service, and they had this really funny video and each of them did something kind of crazy, and then they each wished us a happy Easter before the service started. And what one of the assistant pastors said just captured my attention. He said that the power, the spirit and power of the resurrected Christ dwells in us. And I thought, I need to find where it says that in the Bible. So when I came home today, my husband and I sat on the patio out back, and I did a little Googling, and I found that it's in Romans chapter 8. And did some reading in Romans chapter 8 today, and then I read it in the Message translation. And I just wanted to share with you the message that I read from Romans chapter 8. It says in verse 5, those who think they can do it on their own end up obsessed with measuring their own moral muscle, but never get around to exercising it in real life. Those who trust God's action in them find that God's Spirit is in them, living and breathing God. Obsession with self in these matters is a dead end. Attention to God leads us out into the open, into a spacious, free life. Focusing on the self is the opposite of focusing on God. Anyone completely absorbed in self ignores God, ends up living and thinking more about self than God. That person ignores who God is and what he's doing, and God isn't pleased at being ignored. But if God himself has taken up residence in your life, you can hardly be thinking more of yourself than of him. Anyone, of course, who has not welcomed this invisible but clearly present God, the Spirit of Christ, won't know what we're talking about. But for you who welcome him, in whom he dwells, even though you still experience all the limitations of sin, you yourself experience life on God's terms. It stands to reason, doesn't it, that if the alive and present God who raised Jesus from the dead moves into your life, he'll do the same thing in you that he did in Jesus, bringing you alive to himself. When God lives and breathes in you, and he does as surely as he did in Jesus, you are delivered from that dead life. With his spirit living in you, your body will be as alive as Christ's life was. So don't you see that we don't owe this old do-it-to-yourself life one red cent? There's nothing in it for us, nothing at all. The best thing to do is give it a decent burial and get on with your new life. God's spirit beckons. There are things to do and places to go. This resurrection life you receive from God is not a timid, grave-tending life. It's adventurously expectant, greeting God with a childlike, "What's next, Papa?" I was so moved by that passage today, and I realized that I have a superpower. I have the spirit of the resurrected life of God, of Jesus, living inside me, and it gives me such hope as I head into this next season of the year. So I just wanted to share that with you, that you are a Wonder Woman today, and I hope you'll take that with you through the rest of the week. God bless.